Welcome to our channel. Tonality enthuses Dua Lipa's Dance of Power, which for the sizable portion is a stretch too sweeping from being just a pony in the game. Parallel to how the stone vacates its masquerade if and when the time comes to reproduce, even in the harshest conditions, opening its pores in order to respire, then eventually breaking through the cactus skin to burst into a flower virtually unheard of. Illustrating a fiery side that concrete croon loyalists are attracted to. Hatching training season, the up-to-the-second bird call from her highly projected impending third studio album is a recipe for bringing color to the English-Albanian global pop ball of fire's unfiltered script, written in the stars. An up-grill ingredient for Dua Lipa's omen. The berceuse was produced by Kevin Parker, an Australian vocalist, ballad maker, musician, record producer, and disc jockey. Known for his psychedelic harmonious project Tame Impala, as well as British euphony composer Denny L. Harle. The pair also co-wrote Training Season along with Dua, Caroline Ailin, a Norwegian singer-songwriter, and Canadian artist Tobias Jesso Jr. In the same way they had a finger in how Dua Lipa's Pop Lulu smacked Houdini, a euphoric club-ready ditty fold last November in the stroke of a wrinkling 2023 time period, which besides being glorified by Billboard and Rolling Stone as a neo-psychedelic dance floor ragger, was avowed a pop masterclass by Pitchfork and Vogue. The canon hulk serves a hell-dust principle quislingism that struck a Baroque major chord on the over. I had been on a string of bad dates, and the last one was the final straw. The next morning, I arrived at the studio to Caroline and Tobias asking me how it all went, and I immediately declared, training season is over. And like the best day after debriefs with your mates, we had a lot of laughs. It all quickly came together from there, Dua Lipa said. Gritty exertion, the congruently whelped cinematography to the spanking newfangled banger, training season, was directed by Vincent Haycock from the United States, who is also an editor renowned for his touch of class on English musician Paul McCartney's early days, 2014, as well as Scottish disc jockey and record producer Calvin Harris' Sweet Nothing, 2012, featuring Florence Welch, an English-American singer and songwriter. Something had to give, and Somesuch, a London as well as Los Angeles-based media production company that provides associated motion picture photography, sound, telecasting, publishing, and art development, certainly stepped up to produce the dazzling means of expressive exposé through illustration. The hake of a graphic to training season sparks to life with Dua's voicemail being swamped by rueful messages and second-chance pleas, as the lilt loiters, the latter, who is a two-time Guinness World Records holder, included on the Time 100 Next list in 2021, takes the weight off her feet alone, while she is encircled by men vying for her attention as the room instigates to twirl into pandemonium. And while it is obviously about that feeling when you are just absolutely done telling people, men specifically in this case, how to date you right, it is also about my training season being over and me growing with every experience. I have never felt more confident, clear, or empowered. And while it may be that training season is never over for any of us, you start to see the beauty in finding that person to experience it with. You stop looking for the trainees and become more interested in having someone where you are and someone to grow with, Dua Lipa said. In addition to training season, the offering of jazzy blasts will include Houdini, which has now surpassed 300 million streams globally and was recently certified silver in the UK. Upon release, the beat would reign supreme on the UK airplay charts, making it the 3x Grammy as well as 6x Brit award-winning artist's 11th number one UK airplay record. Whipping up some delicious heartwarming chronicles, the week of its premiere, the cinematography to Houdini set on the summit of YouTube, becoming the top spot music video on planet Earth, in so doing, neither hoodwinked nor fluffing the unthinkable, as it drew in over 12 million views within 24 hours on the latter visual communication streaming platform. Houdini would replicate the purple patch sun, kissing the thumping tune, dance the night from the box office sensation, bubbly Barbie flick, which landed on the Oscars shortlist and earned nominations at the Golden Globes, Critics' Choice Awards, as well as the Grammys.